celebrate the life of our dear, dear brother. Lambert Hyde. I can still see him there in the back row. My name is Brother Nunez. I'll be conducting today. On the stand with me is Bishop Dixon, and he will be presiding. Brothers and sisters, we're going to start our meeting singing hymn number 86, How Great Thou Art, and our opening prayer will be given by James, Brother James Roshka.
Thank you. Dear God, our Heavenly Father, we're so grateful to be here to celebrate our wonderful member and friend. We're thankful for the many friends that he has, and we pray that thy Spirit will be with us this day as we honor this wonderful man. We're grateful to have known this family. We're grateful for thy Son who gave his life that we might know that we will be back with him someday. Father in heaven, we thank thee again for the Spirit and pray that the Holy Ghost will be with all of us as we listen and talk about this wonderful person today, our good friend Lambert Hyde. And I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Now hear from Brother Matthew Reed. We'll offer a prayer tribute, and following Brother Reed, Neville Reed, will also share a scripture reading.
Good afternoon, everyone. Lambert Hyde was a dear friend of my family. My father knew him as Lammy. Many others knew him as Lammy as well. I knew him always as Mr. Hyde. I always thought of him as a close friend to my family, and even when he wasn't around, it was always as if he was watching over me and my family at every moment. I remember early days of my childhood, he would drive me home from school, watching me in the back seat, making sure I was secure, and he would always tell me, or actually tell my father, that he found it a little strange that at such a young age, I would just sit so patiently and not say anything. He was always a joyful soul, and it was amazing to be in his household or be around him or be his friend. I remember the tragedy that I felt when 2 days before my birthday, I had gotten the news that he had passed away, and visiting him upon 3 days afterward, or at least his household, it was quite shocking because walking in, he'd always say something that'd make you laugh, always say something to make you smile. And I'd walk in and there was no joke this time. It was different. And it's because of just the sheer impact he had on me and my family. I want to rejoice and say a prayer for him. Almighty God, we rejoice in your promise of love, joy, and peace. In your mercy, turn the darkness of death in the dawn of life and sorrow, of parting into the joy of heaven. Through our Savior Jesus Christ, who died, rose again, and lived forever. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Good afternoon, all. Today's scripture is taken from the book of Psalm 121, verse 1 to 8. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He hath kept thee, will not slumber. Behold, he hath kept Israel, shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is my keeper, the Lord is my shade upon which my right hand. The sun shall smite thee by day, nor the moon at night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in, this time forth and even more forever. Here at the end of the lessons.
Thank you. We now have a special tribute from Sister Lana Allison. After Sister Allison, we have a special musical presentation by Sister Joy Berta.
Pastor Lee said, my name is Lana Allison. I am group leader and travel agent. So I am giving a tribute as I've known Mr. Lambert Hyde as a traveler with me. I first met him in 2009, and that was by telephone. And I was immediately impressed by the eloquent speaker he was. He wasn't given to verbosity, but he had an excellent command of the English language, and that was very clear from the very first time speaking with him. Since 2010, he has traveled with me, I think, yearly, once, twice, or whatever. I found him to be a man of strong determination. Whatever he set his mind to do, he would do it, despite any restrictions. He loved traveling, and he always thanked me profusely for allowing him to wander all over the world and to see the beauty of God's creation. So he has traveled far and wide, all the way from down under Australia, New Zealand, to above the Arctic Circle in Norway, to Asia. He has been to India, where he wasn't afraid to get onto an elephant's back and rode that elephant. He said, I came here to do this, and nothing is going to stop me. He had much difficulty getting up to the, there was a platform that he had to climb up to get onto the elephant's back. And we were there standing saying, he isn't going to make it. But when we got to the top of the hill, he was there. And that was part of his determination. He was so determined that he would say to me, it is hard, but I'm not giving up, I'm going. And I recall once on a trip, he was having such difficulty. He said, Lana, I don't think I'm going to be able to travel with you anymore. But the moment he got a marketing material, he calls me. And he would say, Schultz, that's his wife, you want to go to so-and-so? And you say, sign me up. We had great joy with him because of his friendliness. Everyone in the group talks about him with love. He was very easy to gravitate to. And because of that, he even found a family member on one of the trips, someone he didn't know. He was having difficulty walking along, and for some reason, this young lady from Canada, she gravitated towards him, helping him along the way. I remember he stopped and rested, and she made sure he was okay. And she said, stay right here, I'll come back to get you when we're ready, which she did. And lo and behold, only to find out they are blood relatives. She's here to with us today from Canada to bid him farewell. He had a fortitude that was so palpable, it didn't take you 2 minutes to see that. In the midst of pain, I could see him grimacing sometimes. There were times when people had to help to lift his ankle to get him onto the bus. And he would grimace and he would look around and say, it's tough, but I'm enjoying it. He was a very humorous person, and many times the humor was about himself. He told me about his large nostrils. And he said it was the brunt of a joke of jokes from his childhood days, because his friends would say two trucks could be parked in his nostrils. And he would have a good laugh. Each time he calls me, sometimes he would tell me, I'm still on the job, because his wife is the boss. I remember one morning, when I got into the office and I looked at my emails, he sent an email at 2 o'clock in the morning. So I called him and I said, what were you doing up at that time? He said, the boss asked me some questions and I didn't have the answer. So I had to get on the computer to find out, because I don't want to lose the job. I assured him that he had the job for a lifetime, So many times he would call and he would say, I'm still on the job. Praise God. His wife stood by him through thick and thin, and he stood by her through thick and thin. Going back to his humorous jokes, one day he called me and he was having some difficulties at the airport with an agent, and he said, I'm going to say it the Jamaican way, the way he said it, verbatim, he said, I hope him in the was all panim, you see? And whatever it was, for those who don't understand, maybe, he was saying that he caused his nostrils to flare. And just by doing that, he resolved the issue and got what he wanted. He loved travel, loved it with a passion. And each time he returned from a trip, he would either call or he would send me a message thanking me. And two words that he always uses, not just with me, highly appreciated. I'm sure you have heard that, highly appreciated. To the point where I would call it Mr. Highly Appreciated. We also had jokes about being Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. And sometimes he would call and I would say to him, who is speaking today? Is it Mr. Hyde or is it Dr. Jekyll? And he would say, it's Dr. Hyde. So he had it spun around. He was a joy to be with. Always makes you laugh. Talk with him for 5 minutes. You're going to have something to laugh about. Easygoing and lovable. In one of his final messages to me, he said, he was about going on a trip and it said, it will be rough going given our arthritic condition, but perseverance will make one conquer. And that's how he lived his life. We will miss him. My travel group will miss him. We loved him and we will continue to love him. God bless you all for coming to celebrate his farewell.
Thank you.
like to thank all of you that have participated so far in this wonderful gathering this morning, this afternoon. Can't help but acknowledge Matthew's words and his feelings. This is a personal note for me. I have a son. I have two sons. I have twin boys. One's name is Matthew as well. And I know that love that you felt from Brother Hyatt is the same love that my boys felt from him and that I feel for him. He is such a genuine, sincere man that really loved everyone and he loved life. We're going to continue our meeting and we're going to have a special tribute from previous bishop, Nick Bianghel. Brother Bianghel will share some words, and after his words, we will hear a tribute from the York Castle High School group from 1958 to 1975. I saw a bunch of you guys with your ties. That's awesome.
Over 10 years ago, I was in a very dark place in my life. Depressed, came to church still, did what I had to do, and back when church was 3 hours, I used to hang out with Carl and the boy there, and we used to talk about BMWs and the engines that they were putting out, and which one was better, German or American. Of course, American always won. But it wasn't very social. I gave one-word answers to those who approached me. My third hour came around for Elders Quorum. I stayed in my seat while Carl dutifully attended his Elders Quorum meeting. Heavenly Father, in his infinite sense of humor, he decided to call me to the bishopric as a counselor. So I had to get to know the people who I'll be serving. And one of the first ones was Lambert Hyde and Claudia Hyde. Sitting in the back row right there. So every Sunday I came by, shook their hand, said good morning to them, and see how they were doing. Eventually a friendship grew from that, and then they started to meet my family. Well, they put two and two together. They knew who my family was, but they didn't know I was related to them. And so every Sunday I made sure that Elizabeth, my daughter, was there to give them hugs and say hi to them. It got to the point where we were pretty much family. Lambert, every time he sees Elizabeth, how's my little princess doing? With a big smile and a big hug. And then when Ethan was born, my youngest, that was another grandchild in the books. How's my little prince doing? He's growing so fast. And his friendship proved to be fruitful, again, under God's plan. About a year and a half after I was called as a counselor of the bishop, I was called to be a bishop. I felt highly unworthy to do so. But President Richards encouraged and invited my wife and I, Chantal, to pray and to counsel the Lord who will be my counselors. However, without prayer, without contemplation, immediately Lambert came to mind. And Chantal and I both had that impression from the get-go. And I can honestly say that he served dutifully and lovingly in that calling. Kind of reminiscing when Allison was talking about Lambert. And there are many activities we had to go to, especially when, with the youth. And we all know he had that bum knee.
but he walked to the activities. He made sure the youth knew that he loved them. He didn't let anything stop him from going. There's a couple activities where it was a big fields, you know, youth conference or what have you, and he would just walk between fields. He wouldn't stop, and I asked him, how you doing? He's like, I'm richly blessed. And we hear about his testimony in the prayer that Brother Ross mentioned. Whenever he shared his testimony, that voice, and for me it's an accent, you know, the Jamaican accent, but the eloquence, again mentioned by Lana, was paramount. The deep feelings that he had when he shared his testimony about the gospel of Jesus Christ and his love that he has for his Savior, you felt it. And every time he spoke, the congregation was left quiet to dwell in the spirit that he brought into the room. And despite Claudia being the boss of the house, he always made sure that I had ginger beer whenever I visited. And not to disrespect any other Jamaicans here, but I think she made the best ginger beer in the house. And she always had a gallon ready for me, and even if just stopped in for a surprise visit, Lander would be like, Claudia, give me some ginger beer. And it was good. I savored every drop of that ginger beer. And my kids didn't like it that much when they were smaller, which was good by me because I took the rest of it. I was like, I'm good. Another sweet memory I had when he served with me in the bishopric was, yeah, for those who don't know, we take turns conducting the services every month. And when it was his turn, it's customary that we acknowledge the presiding authority. In this case, in this meeting, is Bishop Dixon. So when I was in the meeting, you know, it was usually me. And he will go ahead and say, presiding Bishop Byangle, and just look at me to make sure they said my name right. So my name in Spanish is Beyond Hill, and if you want to Americanize it, it's Beyond Hell. But he always just, one way or another, made it to a different name and just looked me for approval. And I will just lovingly nod, like, we're good, and the audience, just like you, will chuckle as well. And so for the 2 years he served with me, every time he conducted, it was like, yes, he did, all right, good. But during that time, you know, again, looking out for his health, you know, we had him released, and he was happy to sit back in the back with his wife again. Shortly afterwards, I moved to Georgia, and we kept in touch, mainly through text, but we called each other on a regular basis, and, you know, I was kind of like you. He kept me abreast with all the trips that he was going on, and when he was leaving, when he was coming back, and every once in a while, he'll forget. You know, come down and visit. It's like, hey, stop by. You know, you're okay. He's like, no, I'm good. I was sorry. I was on a trip. And I let you know. Don't worry about, you know, we're good. He's like, all right. But I made a point that, you know, at least every month, we just reached out to each other to make sure that he was okay. And I would like to leave you with an invitation as well as couple of lessons to remember him by. Now, Lana mentioned that he was Mr. Highly Appreciative. With me, he was always grateful, and he always expressed his love. Even at a time that I cannot even imagine losing your daughter, he was grateful for the love that he was receiving. He was grateful for his knowledge of the gospel. Though it may be strange to many, he was grateful for that experience, even though he missed her dearly. He always ended the text message with my heartfelt love to Chantal, Elizabeth, and Ethan. Or if he didn't use their names, Chantal, my princess, my prince. And many times were those words still richly blessed. Brothers and sisters, he is my brother from another mother. I love him dearly. He was one of the few that took me out of the hell that I was in. And I will be eternally grateful for him because he did that. He accepted my family as his own. Whenever we visited, his boss, aka Claudia, will hide the treats, but he knew where they were and will give them to my kids and then stick one in for himself. And he's like, don't tell the boss. But I will miss him. He is a great man. Again, as a reminder, the two lessons I'd like to leave you with, to always have a sense of gratitude. No matter what's going on with your life, because whatever happens in our lives, this too shall pass. And always have a heart full of love. And I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Claudette Watson, and I'm a past student of York Castle High School in Brownstown, St. Anne, Jamaica, the illustrious institution which Lambert attended from 1961 to 1968. I refer to our school as the illustrious institution because this is how Lammy always referred to his past high school, of which he was so proud. I'm asking all the past students present here today to stand in solidarity with me as I present this tribute. I see myself standing here to give this tribute on behalf of York Castle for Lambert as a privilege. But I personally think this is a very large shoe for me to fill, and I'm not sure I can give it the justice it deserves, because Lambert was one of the greatest orators to have passed through the walls of York Castle High School. As I have listened to him many times when he would be called upon suddenly to speak, and on hearing him speak, you would think that this speech was written beforehand and well rehearsed. Those of us who were here for his daughter's funeral can remember that speech. I started York Castle High School a few years after Lambert did, and in those days, the seniors were almost revered, so I knew Lambert at school, but not to talk to one-on-one, but admired him from afar as my head boy, a great athlete, and a great debater. I met up with him as an adult, and we have become very good friends, but I'm not here to give a tribute to the man he had become, but to give a tribute to his life and work at York Castle. I will take excerpts from the things past students who knew him and mingled with him at school had written before and since he passed. One of such said, this was sent to Lambert and he shared it with me. Just as I remember your stellar performance when you beat Homewood's star mile racer called Peart, a performance truly placed the YCHS Alumni Hall of Fame. If it happened in 2024, we could all have seen it on videotape. Training for the stellar race. Brother Lambert got up early every morning. He hopped, skipped, and jumped over Pound Hill. This is a modern day miracle. He kept on training and training until Pound Hill has also always been very steep. Even the camel did not walk that route to his home. He made an exit near Max Brint to the Tabernacle Church. He needed to get to Paris or Rome. Brother Lamy ran up the road and passed Goshen. We thought a play of a stellar one, a play. Girls from St. Hilda's cheered him on, kept on admiring his prowess until this day. When his stamina brought him to Alexandria, we thought our big brother could turn back, beating Peart pounded on his head. Stamina is something he will not lack. Rector thought it was the wrong strategy. Wade Van Rieck, you have to run the whole mile. He was half lap ahead of everyone. The stellar one had adopted a new style. Peart used his old strategy with Brother Lamy. He will play cat and mouse when the results of this race is known. We will share it with Sweet Emily on What's Your Grouse. There, 3.5 laps out of the 5 and counting, the stellar one had put the mile race to bed. Peart flexed all his muscles. He made every effort. Let this not be unsaid. The stellar one beat Peart by 0.5 lap. The girls from St. Hilda's burst into cheers. From this day on, going forward, the stellar one could do no wrong. We have to give him his title. The great Lamy Hyde was never afraid of the cleansing blood of Jesus. And he responded to this, because this was written before he died, he passed. I was not aware that my performance that day is so vividly remembered. I smiled, for it was one of my admirable accomplishments. Claudette is simple, who is on the Lord's side, who will serve the King. And this is another expert from somebody who was much younger than the other person. I probably crossed Lambert only 1 year in school. It's unlikely that we ever interacted, as such was the hierarchy of high school. I, however, always remembered him to be a giant of a man, not physically, but with a presence and a persona that I always admired. Near 50 years later, we reconnected at the Florida chapter, and while not as mobile, he still remained a giant of a man. And this is from somebody who was at school in his same class. Lambert was literally a giant of a man at school, although he was not big in stature, and he was particularly good at sports and running. We could depend on Lambert for getting those points, for winning the athletic trophy on each occasion. This made him very popular, especially with the young ladies. And I envied him just a little bit for that. And Claudia, on behalf of all the York Castle Pass students worldwide, we do not really know how to adequately convey our sympathies, but we stand with you in solidarity today and in the future. We do know that the God who Lambert served will be with you, and many of us are only a phone call away. And we will answer if you call. Lambert, our friend, we all miss you, but we know you have climbed to higher heights to meet your Savior, and I can only imagine the meeting with your friend Joe Tuller and your chanting of the school motto, Nil Sine Magno Labore, translated, nothing without hard work. Lamy, you are You are truly missed and will never be forgotten. Walk good, my friend.
Thank you, sister. We do have a special request. We do have time for one individual who might be inspired or touched by the Spirit to come up here for a brief tribute to our dear brother. I'll give you 30 seconds if you want to come up, somebody. Thank you. After her words, we're going to conclude with the closing remarks from Bishop Vernon Dixon. And after Bishop Dixon's words, we will sing hymn number 152, Till We Meet Again. And our closing prayer will be given by Brother Earl Harris.
Hi everyone. I just want to give a tribute to Lammy. Just as the Lanners already told you guys, we were on a cruise and somehow they were something that's attachment to this person. And when his wife wanted to go, I said, go ahead, I'll stay with him. She said, you sure? I'm pretty sure, but I wasn't sure what was happening. But we'll just stick together for the whole day. I was like, you guys go, I will. But one thing I can remember, that when he told me that we were related by my brother, I'm like, what? This can't be right. This can never be right. And then he said to me, the night I remember he called me, he said, I'm inviting you up to my room. And then he said, you know what, I've been going traveling for maybe 21 years, and this is like one of my best years just to meet you. And he gave me like a whole set of money. And I was like, you don't have to do that. He said, yes, just to meet you. And as everybody said, he said, I highly appreciate you. I highly appreciate you. You know, I love you, you know. And he, while I'm on the trip, he makes sure I'm okay. There was nothing I didn't want that he wouldn't give. So I'm really going to miss him. And every morning, he always sends me like a kind word. Even when I'm not well, you're okay. So I couldn't miss this opportunity to be here. That's my few words.
Thank you so much. The first time I ever officiated at a funeral, I had just had surgery a few days previous, and apparently we're going to repeat that again this week. I've canceled everything else this week so that I would be able to have enough strength to be here today. Brother Lambert Hyde was one of the truly best people I have known. For years, we would meet here in the building in different congregations, just different times because of the number of people in the area. And so we would just, you know, see each other in the hall here or there. And he didn't know me and I didn't know him, but I felt his love. And we became hallway friends whenever we saw each other. The first time that I really interacted with the family was when we had the funeral services for their daughter. And that's when I learned that Brother Hyde wasn't just a loving, generous, wonderfully friendly, kind individual. But I learned the depth of who he was. As he faced a challenge that I can't even imagine, with incredible grace and love and strength, that resilience, that perseverance we've talked about. He was a truly, truly good man. It is difficult to deal with loss and separation. Death is hard. It is always hard. It is important for us to hang on that all, to hang on to all that remains, the influence, the memories, the strength of those that have gone before and those that we will see again. President Nelson has frequently said that the only way to take sorrow out of death is to take love out of life. What we feel now is love being forced to be held at a distance. It is also a feeling that we are designed to feel, to remind us that there is more, much more, that this, where we are now, is the time away from our eternal family. That where we came from is where we will return. And that we will be together for an eternity so much longer than the time that we have here. As Paul says, we were born to die, we die to live. In the Psalms we are taught, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. Lambert was one of those. And the prophet Joseph Smith taught that God has a time appointed when he will bring all of his subjects who have obeyed his voice and kept his commandments into his celestial rest. This rest is of such perfection and glory that man has need of a preparation before he can, according to the laws of that kingdom, enter it and enjoy its blessings. God has given certain laws to the human family, which, if observed, are sufficient to prepare them to inherit this rest. The purpose of this earth is to gather and bind all together in sacred covenant through Christ to our loving Heavenly Father as children prepared to return to be with him. This is the great plan of happiness, the great an eternal plan of deliverance from death. Scriptures teach there are two deaths, a physical death, but even more significant, a spiritual death, a separation from God. And that is the significance of the Savior of this world. He came not to save us in our sins, but to redeem us from our sins on condition of our repentance, that we may overcome that spiritual death that keeps us separate from him. We learn difficult trials, following his example, though he were a son, yet learned he obedience by the things which he suffered. It is after much tribulation that the blessings come. In fact, it is through tribulation. It is through tribulation sometimes that the greatest blessings of all come into our lives. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. There will be a lot of weeping. I know that is true. But I offer my witness that through that will come joy. There is a joy to come, beautiful and holy, a linking together and a strengthening. Ye must press forward with a steadfastness in Christ, having a perfect brightness of hope and a love of God and of all men. Wherefore, if ye shall press forward, feasting upon the word of Christ, and endure to the end, behold, thus saith the Father, ye shall have eternal life. Our brother Lambert showed us that path through his life and example. He sought to know our Savior Jesus Christ through the choices that he made and the life he chose to live, the love that he radiated and that all of us, I'm confident every one of us have felt. Fear not, even unto death. For in this world your joy is not full, but in me your joy is full. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. I am so grateful for the peace that comes through our Savior Jesus Christ. I'm thankful for the love that we feel, even when it has to be held at a distance for a time, even when that love becomes grief. I'm thankful that we had it, and that we have it, that we will have it again. I'm grateful that not that long ago, Claudia and Lambert had a chance to be sealed together in the temple of God for time and all eternity as a family united. And I know that they have an eternity of love and joy ahead. My mother passed earlier this year. And even though I still pick up the phone every once in a while thinking, oh, I should share that with her, and then remind myself that it'll be a little while until I get to do that. I offer my witness that I have felt her presence. I know she's not far. I know she is close. I know Lambert's close as well. He will always be close. I offer my witness that our loving Father has not and will not leave us alone. He will never leave us without hope, that his plan is a plan of change, growth, and opportunity, a plan of peace in this life and joy in the life to come, through the power and atoning grace of Jesus Christ. I know he is the Savior of us all, through which we find forgiveness and hope and healing, even when things are hard, especially when things are hard. I pray that we can remember our good brother, that we can seek to live a life following the very best of what he showed us, that we can choose to find the joy that is available through our Savior. I testify of the joy that comes through our loving Savior, Jesus Christ, and I say these things in his name. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Thank you. Our kind and gracious Heavenly Father, we're so grateful for this opportunity that we've had to celebrate the life of thy son, Lambert. We're grateful for his example that he has set of charity, of love, of temperance, of intelligence. We're grateful for the spirit that he has brought into each one of our lives. And we ask that thou receive him with open arms and with love. And we ask for those same open arms of love to be around his dear sweet wife. We're grateful, Father, for the plan of salvation, for the blessing it is in our lives, for the knowledge and peace that it brings. And we're grateful for the sacrifice of thy son. And we offer this prayer in his name, even Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
We'd like to ask those that have been invited to participate in the recessional to please come up with the direction of the funeral director. Is that there? They're right in the back. Yeah, specifically the pallbearers. Hello, good evening, everybody. At this moment, we're going to go ahead and prepare and head down to the final resting place for our dearly beloved brother. For those that may have not gotten the program, the address for the cemetery is on the back of the program, and I want to give you the address just in case if you didn't get one. It's going to be at Forest Lawn South Memorial Gardens. The address is 2401 Southwest 64th Avenue, Fort Lauderdale. The zip code is 33317. Once again, that's Forest Lawn South Memorial Gardens, 2401 Southwest 64th Avenue, Fort Lauderdale. The zip code is 33317. For those that will be accompanying us to the cemetery, we do have a professional escort service that will be leading the way. So for those that would like to follow in the processional, you can. We just ask that you turn on your hazard lights. You'll drive as close as possible and be as safe as possible. Thank you. Pallbearers, please come to the front. Sister Claudia, or exit, then we can all follow.
careful. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask all those if you could draw in a little closer.
Can I hear you over there?
Want some more people coming?
Yeah, there's a few over there. I don't know if they can hear you when you call them in.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask everyone to come a little closer for us, please. All those are participating.
I'm going to have you stand up. Okay?
Stand where?
Stand right here, okay?
You got it?
Yeah. Don't step on me.
Okay. Thank you. Welcome to the graveside ceremony. We're grateful for all of you who showed up. We've had the opportunity to hear many wonderful words about Lambert and the wonderful life he lived and the example he left for all of us. It was just a few short years ago we were here with him and Claudia when their daughter passed. And it was a very somber moment, but one that we know that we are united, as Bishop Dixon said, as a family for forever. And while it's difficult to miss family who are separated from us, as Bishop Dixon said, it's a wonderful that we have the knowledge we'll all be together again, and that joyous reunion we all look forward to as we get back together and spend our time with loved ones who passed on before and wait for those who are behind us to come join us. It'll be a wonderful time as we remember our family, our friends, and all those whom we've associated with. And as the scriptures say, that we will have that same sociality we have here, only there will be coupled with eternal glory, which glory we do not now have. And it will be a wonderful time when we get together and see our friends, see our family members, and give them this opportunity to reunite and share our love with each other. And I'm looking forward to that day when I get to go see Lambert again and express my gratitude for a life well lived and for an example well done. At the, we'll go ahead now and dedicate his grave. So we'll have a brief prayer, and then we'll be concluded here. Our Heavenly Father, by the authority of the Holy Melchizedek Priesthood, we dedicate this grave as the final resting place of Lambert Hyde and pray that thou would bless and protect and hallow this ground, that he may come forth in the first resurrection and be able to be surrounded by family and friends. We're grateful for thy Son who makes our resurrection a certainty. We're grateful for his atoning sacrifice and his life on our behalf. We pray that thou would comfort all of us at Lambert's life, that we may be able to remember him, his good example, and live a life full of love and gratitude for each day and for our family and friends. We pray that thou would comfort us all, and especially Claudia with her loss, and also with the knowledge that Lambert had great joy with the reunion with his daughter, and look forward to that joy when we have that same opportunity to reunite with those who've gone before. We're grateful for thy Son and all he's done for us, and grateful for the Holy Spirit, which brings peace and joy and comfort to our lives in times of sorrow. And we say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So we'll give a few minutes then for anybody who'd like to have a minute alone, but that concludes the official part of the service.
Hello, thank you for allowing our family to serve your family in your time of need. Here at Bell's Funeral Home and Cremation, we'll continue to pray for your family until we meet again. Remember, families only deserve the best.